In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, we gather as a community of Christ to celebrate this 25th Sunday in ordinary time. We pray and open our hearts to the ways of discipleship, that the Lord may teach us the way to greatness through the way of the cross, opening our hearts to His guidance and through His good words, forming us and shaping us to be well. For us to be less unworthy to celebrate the mysteries of Christ's love, let us implore the forgiveness by which we are all redeemed and saved. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Please be seated.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The wicked say, "Let us beset the just one, because he is obnoxious to us. He sets himself against our doings, reproaches us for transgressions of the law, and charges us with violations of our training. Let us see whether his words be true. Let us find out what will happen to him. For if the just one be the Son of God, God will defend him and deliver him from the hand of his foes. with revilement and torture, let us put the just one to the test, that we may have proof of his gentleness and try his patience. Let us condemn him to a shameful death, for according to his own words, God will take care of him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
O God, by your name save me, and by your might defend my cause. O God, hear my prayer, hearken to the words of my mouth. For the haughty have risen up against me, the ruthless seek my life, they set not God before their eyes. Behold, God is my helper. The Lord sustains my life. Freely will I offer you sacrifice. I will praise your name, O Lord, for its goodness.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Beloved, where is jealousy and selfish ambition exists, there is disorder and every foul practice. But the wisdom from above is first of all, pure, then peaceable, gentle, compliant, full of mercy and good fruits, without inconstancy or insincerity. And the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace for those who cultivate peace. Where do the wars and where do conflicts among you come from? Is it not from your passions that make war within your members? You covet but do not possess. You kill and envy, but you cannot obtain. You fight and wage war. You do not possess because you do not ask. You ask but do not receive because you ask wrongly to spend it in your passions. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
Your word is a lamp
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus and his disciples left from there and began a journey through Galilee, but he did not wish anyone to know about it. He was teaching his disciples and telling them, "The Son of Man is to be handed over to men, and they will kill him, and 3 days after his death, the Son of Man will rise." But they did not understand the saying, and they were afraid to question him. They came to Capernaum, and once inside the house, he began to ask them, "What were you arguing about on the way?" But they remained silent. They had been discussing among themselves on the way who was the greatest. Then he sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "If anyone wishes to be first, he shall be the last of all and the servant of all." Taking a child, he placed it in their midst, and putting his arms around it, he said to them, "Whoever receives one child such as this in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives not me, but the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Isang mapagpalang gabi po sa inyong lahat, my beloved brothers and sisters. And although the weather outside is not that good, it's been raining all throughout the afternoon, we thank the Lord for gathering us this evening as we celebrate this Holy Mass. No coach of a certain sport team would like or would just let his team crumble into losing streak. Wala naman pong coach ang gustong o hahayaang matambakan na lamang yung kanyang team at uupo na lang siya sa gilid at sasabihin, "Bahala kayo dyan. Maglaro kayo, magpatambak kayo. Ako, dito lang ako." No choir master would like to leave his choir just singing nothing or voices going to and fro at sasabihin niya, "Okay lang, magkamali. Bahala kayo dyan." Or maybe no parent would like his or her child to just see his or her life going down. Nagpapariwara na anak ninyo at sasabihin ninyo, "Hayaan nyo siya, bahala siya, buhay niya yan eh." Bumabagsak na sa eskwelahan, wala nang baon, at sasabihin ninyo, "Bahala ka, maghanap ka ng magulang mo." No person would like or leave another one, most especially the one he is responsible to, seeing him or her going down, defeating, losing, or crumbling. I would like to invite you to look at least one detail in our gospel. Sa pagkakataong ito, may isang nais si Jesus. He did not wish anyone to know that he will be going to Galilee. Because he is with his disciples, ayaw niya munang magpaistorbo sa madaming tao at gusto niya na ang kanyang mga alagad na lamang muna ang kanyang makasama. Bakit? Mark, in our gospel, made mention the reason. He was teaching his disciples and would like to tell them something. For 2 consecutive Sundays, may mga pagkakamaling pag-iisip ang mga alagad. Last week, if you would remember, Jesus was asking his disciples, "Who do people say that I am? Who do you say that I am?" And Peter gave the right and the best answer, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And after that, Jesus said, "I will be handed over to men, I will be crucified, and I will be raised." At ang mga alagad, tila nagulat, lalo na si Pedro, "That should not happen." And after that event, Peter took Jesus aside, rebuking Jesus. And here comes Jesus correcting the mindset of Peter. And again, we have the same incident. Baka ang mga alagad may mga iba na rin pag-iisip patungkol kay Jesus. At si Jesus bilang mabuting guro, hindi niya hinayaan ang mga alagad niyang maniwala sa sinasabi ng tao at kung ano-ano na lamang ang kanilang malalaman. And he said, "Something is wrong. Huddle up. I would like to tell you something. I would like to teach you something. I would not want you to be in the losing streak, but I want you to be great." And this is primarily, my dear brothers and sisters, the invitation of our readings this Sunday. We thank this God who has been reminding us, huddling us as a family, reminding us na medyo nagkakamali na tayo, naliligaw na tayo ng landas, sumasabog na ang ating isipan. The Lord correcting us and leading us again to the path of greatness. We've heard how the just one was rejected or despised by those men we call the wicked ones. Dahil ang tapat na taong ito ay tinuturuan sila ng katotohanan, pero ang mga taong iba ay umaayaw at pumapalag. And similarly, in our second reading, we've heard how every gift of wisdom may hopefully touch the hearts of people to direct our actions to greatness and to direct our lives to goodness. Sana walang taong buhay ngayon na hahayaan na lamang magkamali ang mga tao o hahayaan na lamang magkagulo ang mga tao sa madaming mga pag-iisip na mayroon ngayon. But let us take a look how Jesus gathered once again His disciples, huddled them once again, and reminded them, "Please, stop what you are thinking about. And this is the way to greatness. That you embrace your cross, be one among the least, and be like little children." At sana nga po, hindi maging totoo ang karanasan na ito sa atin bilang mga Kristiyano at bilang mga pamilya at komunidad. Nahahayaan na lang natin ang mga kabataan na tahakin na lamang ang mga maliliit o tila mga cheap na landas sa buhay na ito. Sana hindi natin hayaan na kahit mga marurunong na tao ipaglalaban kahit mali. Like Jesus, He gathered once again His disciples and told them, "This is the right thing to do. This is the right mindset. This is how you are to do it." And that is the heart of a good person. You would not want others to be disappointed, to be set out with no direction in life. But you want that person, you want that beloved one to embrace a good life. We pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that we may have that heart of Jesus, a heart ready to direct each other to the way of greatness. Huwag nating hayaang ang bawat isa maging dahilan sa pagkakabagsak ng bawat isa. We let ourselves be instruments of ways of greatness through the way of the cross and through the way of the love of God.
Please stand.
We profess our faith. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who was spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Christ, our Lord, predicted his saving death and resurrection. Through him, the suffering servant, let us bring our petitions to the Father of all mercies. After every prayer, we shall all say, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Pope, who is the servant of the servants of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace and harmony between those nations set against one another, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to jealousy and destructive competition among members of our families, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christians working for the welfare and protection of children in our community, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the faithful departed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our own intentions and lift up to the Lord all of the intentions offered in this Mass and our prayers for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father of our Savior, these prayers we bring before you express our faith in your Son, who humbled himself to die on the cross for us, and rose again to be our glorious Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Pray, dearly beloved, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, the Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even the fashion for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, joined with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus, our brother, taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to say,
Amen.
Deliver us, Lord, that we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord. Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for peace. God, our Heavenly Father, Lord of peace and justice,
We humbly come before you during this time of escalating geopolitical tensions in our part of the world. Through the years, you have sustained our faith in you as a nation. It is our faith in your divine providence that has made us survive the countless natural and human-caused calamities that have come our way in our history as a people. Spare us, Lord, from the horrors of war. Hear our pleas as we cry out to you. Have mercy on us, Lord. Rescue us from the malevolent forces that influence world leaders. For we believe that our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. We pray for our leaders, entrusted with making crucial decisions for our nation. We place all our hopes in you, seeking your forgiveness and mercy for the times when our fears and suspicions have tainted our perceptions with ethnic biases and prejudices verging on racism. We earnestly pray, Lord, that you make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us bring love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Our Lady, Queen of Peace,
pray for us.
Saint Michael, the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Francis of Assisi,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calunsod,
pray for us.
Before the final blessing, we would like to extend our gratitude to all of you in the name of our Rector Monsignor Rolando de la Cruz and the whole of the Manila Cathedral staff for your presence and for your generosity as we celebrate this Holy Mass. Sa mga first-timers po dito sa Manila Cathedral at sa inyo pong lahat na naririto, maligayang pagdating po at nagpapasalamat tayo sa Diyos sa inyong kabutihan. Purihin po natin ang Panginoon. We extend as well our gratitude and our love to our Manila Cathedral servants and staff for their dedication and service to make this celebration solemn and meaningful. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May Almighty God bless you in His kindness and pour out saving wisdom upon you forever and ever.
Amen.
May He nourish you always with the teachings of the faith and make you persevere in holy deeds forever and ever.
Amen.
May He turn your steps towards Himself and show you the path of charity and peace forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Amen.